Today we will start diode basics, which is very fundamental in electronics. Diode is basically a active device that conducts current only in one direction. The electrical circuit symbol of diode is shown here, and we are very familiar with diode because you are already gone through the basic electronic subjects. So this one is the electrical symbol of diode, and here I am showing the two terminal device, anode and cathode, and the electrical circuit symbol, the above one and the below. This figure shows a commercial available diode, which is simply 1N4007. Suppose if you are going to a market and you want to purchase diode, so you have to say I want 1N4007, or so many series are there, but this one is the very basic, and in your lab you have to do experiment using this diode. So this diode is 1N4007. This portion is your anode, and the silver one lining is there, and this portion is your cathode. So this one is very fundamental, conventional, or very basic regarding the diode. So in this lecture we will discuss the basic thing regarding diode that you already known, but we have to go through the basic. After that we will cover some fundamental clipper circuit, clamper circuit, using the concept of diode. So we have to revise the diode basics. So we have to start with diode. So diode is basically a simplest fundamental nonlinear circuit element that conducts current only in one direction. So diode is the very fundamental circuit element in electronics that conducts current only in one direction. This diode is having some IV characteristics. So for a very ideal diode, if we have this ideal diode having two terminal anode and cathode, and if we are giving some voltage V greater than equals to 0, then this diode will conduct current from left to right, from anode to cathode. And if the voltage is less than 0, there will be no current. So the ideal characteristics in which the voltage current waveform, how it looks, this one. So very simple. So forward bias, when we are giving positive voltage, there will be some current, and if the voltage is less than 0, there should be zero current in the circuit. So this one is our simple ideal current voltage characteristics. So for more visualization, you just think about forward bias when there is positive voltage. So when positive voltage V greater than 0, there should be some current, or V equals to 0, because you are telling that this is an ideal one, so there should be current. And if the voltage is less than 0, I will be 0. So this is a very basic one, a very basic concept that we have to keep in mind. Then if such situation is there for ideal one, when V is just greater than or equals to 0, there should be some current from anode to cathode. When V less than 0, current will be 0 in the circuitry, or this one become open circuited, or say reverse bias. And in forward bias condition, V greater than equals to 0 and some current, so this one looks like a closed circuit. This one is very simple thing, you know, but I am just repeating all these things because this concept we had to take care for the problem solving in clipper, clamper, and so many diode based circuitry. Very simple, you have to know this very basic concept. Through that concept we can amplify our skill to solve various electronic circuit based on diode. So these are the thing. So now this one I already told, diode is a very fundamental electronic circuit element which is non-linear in nature, means ID, VD are not linear, just like resistor. Resistor have a linear characteristic, but the diode have a non-linear characteristics, and that expression will be ID equals to IS e to the power q VD by eta kT minus 1. If we plot this ID VD curve, ID in the y axis and VD in the x axis, it will looks like. So forward bias, for VD greater than 0, it will current will be increasing after some voltage, and in the reverse bias, the current will be constant for some time and then it decreases. So that is the breakdown region, reverse bias region, and forward. For the silicon diode, the cut-in voltage will be 0.7 volt. For germanium, 0.3 volt. For if some gallium arsenide based diode, some compound diode, so it for the gallium arsenide, this should be 1.2 volt. So mostly we have to think about silicon and germanium. So here in this expression, ID equals to IS, so IS is your saturation current, VD is the voltage across the diode, the term K is your Boltzmann constant, the value should be 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 joule per Kelvin, the Boltzmann constant, very famous constant, you have to know, remember this thing, and T is the temperature in Kelvin, Q is the charge, electronic charge, an electron 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19, and eta with the ideality vector. Eta will be 1 for silicon and germanium, and eta value is 2 for compound one. So K value I already told, 1.38 into 10 to the power minus 23 joule per Kelvin, electronic charge 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. So other thing, you know, ID VD, the voltage across the VD with the voltage across the diode, ID current across the diode, Q the electronic charge, eta, ideality vector 1 for indirect semiconductor, silicon, germanium. For the direct semiconductor, it should be 2. But we have to mostly focus on eta equals to 1, K Boltzmann constant, and T is the temperature in Kelvin. This one is a very simple thing you have to know. So, because this one is the first class, so we have to go through the basics. So, now silicon diode. So, silicon diode, we already told the cut-in voltage is 0.7 volt. So for silicon diode, this one is just, if this one is a silicon based diode, both are silicon based diode, and this one is forward bias, means we are giving a positive voltage across the anode one. So the voltage between these two ends should be 0.7 volt. If this point is A and B, so AB voltage, if we measure the voltage, it will be 0.7 volt during the forward bias. And this one is actually just switch is closed. In reverse bias, it should be open. If this one is a germanium diode, it should be 0.3 volt. And it's in reverse bias condition, when they are giving negative voltage across the anode, should be open circuited. Or for germanium one, 0.3 volt. Now for silicon one, it is 0.3. So this concept we have to utilize for solving so many problems in silicon diode based problem, clipper, clamper, voltage doubler, anywhere you can use. If nothing is written, so you have to think the diode is ideal one. If silicon diode is written, you have to take care 0.7 volt for silicon, for germanium 0.3 volt. So now the application. So application, this type of diode is generally used to convert AC voltage to its pulsating DC. The simplest one is your rectifier circuit. In rectifier circuit, we can use the DC voltage. We are for the generation of DC voltage using the AC one, and various waveform we can generate using the diode as per our desire. And in logic circuitry, suppose we have to make OR gate, AND gate, so using that diode you can make. So after few slides I will show you how to make the diode based logic circuit. So in this lecture I will show the two input AND or two input OR gate. You can make 3 input, 4 input, anything, but the basic one is 2 input. So I will show you after few more slides. So now we have to start with some simple problem. So I am taking this problem from microelectronics book, Sadia Smith, and a very fundamental problem. And we have to think how, in which manner we have to think. So what the question is? There is a question in which we are giving a sinusoidal input Vs equals to 24 cos theta. Some cosine signal we are giving where the peak amplitude is 24 volt. Then we have to find the fraction of each cycle, find the fraction of each cycle during the diode conducts. Means we have to find the cycle where the diode conducts, also find the peak value of the diode current, maximum peak value in the diode current, and the maximum reverse bias voltage that appears across the diode. The figure is given below. So just don't think about this figure right now. You just think there is a 24 cos theta, some sinusoidal signal for the voltage source, and this one is the circuitry. We are giving a 100 ohm, some source resistance is there, and diode and 12 volt. So in such case, we have to find the for which cycle the diode will conduct. So in such situation, the first thing, if any diode, first we have to think at what instant the diode will conduct. Means diode will be short circuited in what situation. So for such cases, we have to think the diode is short circuited, or we can say it is conducting, but the current during the transition phase, the current will be zero. Means this diode is just a short conducting, but during that time there should be zero current in the circuitry. So how? Means so in such case, first we have to find the transition voltage where the diode will just conduct, but during that time there will be zero current in the circuit, just short circuited, but there will be zero current. So that thing we have to find, what is the transition voltage, transition above which the diode will conduct or not conduct, that will think. So for find this concept, we have to just apply Kirchhoff's voltage law in that loop. So it will give Vs minus 12 volt equals to 0. Because we are thinking this during the transition voltage, there will be no current. I should be 0, the ID should be 0, there is no current. So Vs plus Vs, so Vs then minus 12 volt. Simple Kirchhoff's voltage law. Those who don't know Kirchhoff's voltage law, you just go and learn Kirchhoff's voltage law and current law. It is very simple. Here plus, so Vs then I is 0, so no need to do anything. Minus 12 equals to 0. So we say Vs equals to 12. So this one is the sinusoidal signal of the source voltage. Now this Vs is 12 volt, is a line, we can say, parallel to x-axis. This signal source is a voltage with a time in the x-axis. So this one is a constant term, so this constant term will be parallel to the x-axis. So I am drawing this line, Vs equals to 12 volt. Yes or no? Okay, so Vs equals to 12, 24 cos theta line, curve is there. So above this one is your transition voltage. So above 12 volt, if this voltage means this sinusoidal one is varying from 0 to 24. So here this point is 12. So if it go above 12, like 13, 14, 15, 16, or like that, anything, 24, 23, like that. So above this line, this voltage will be more than 12. Yes or no? So if this voltage is more than 12 volts, so this become forward bias. So the diode becomes forward bias, and we can say this one is in the on state, diode is on state above the line 12 volt. Yes or no? Very simple concept is there. If this voltage is above 12 volt, this transition voltage, first sinusoidal signal is there, source, you just make it. After that, you just find the transition voltage where the diode becomes on state. So during what voltage this one become transition voltage. Transition voltage Vs equals to 12 volt by just applying Kirchhoff's voltage law. So above 12 volt, you just think this line you just draw and just think above this line what should be the diode will be on or off, just think. Below this line diode will be on or off, just think. So above this one means above 12 volt in the signal source, if this one is 13 or 14, 15, 16, anything, so it will be on because this voltage is more than this one. So diode will be on state above 12 volt and diode is off during the this below this 12 means 11, 10, 9, 8 like that. Here also the diode will be in off. So when diode is on, the current will be flow. Yes or no? So maximum current. So maximum current how much flow? Maximum up to 24 minus 12 by something. Okay. So now we put Vs 24 cos theta. So conduction angle will be 60 degree. So this should be 60 and this total should be 2 theta. Okay, so this one is the conduction angle. Okay, so this one is basically 1/3 of the cycle. It's a very simple concept. You just think 5, 10 or 20 minutes, 50 minutes, half an hour. And if you know this concept, you can easily make any clipper circuit using this transition voltage. Any circuit is there, you have to find the transition voltage. Then you have to draw that line over the signal source. And we have to decide where the diode is on or off. Okay. So now when diode is on, input voltage is appears at the output waveform. Yes or no? When diode is on, the input voltage is appears across the output. There should be some output, some resistance will be there for the output. So this voltage will be same as that of this one. So if diode is on, output one output current, output voltage like sinusoidal one, during that phase it will looks like this one. Yes or no? And this voltage will be appears across the output. When diode is off, there will be no voltage. So there should be zero voltage. So when diode is on, input voltage appears as the output waveform, and the diode off, the voltage will be zero due to the open circuited. So peak value of diode current already discussed, maximum voltage 24 minus 12 by 100 ohm. So this one is 0.12, and the maximum reverse voltage across the diode, maximum minus 24, peak voltage is 24, minus 48 volt peak to peak, 48 volt peak to peak. So 24 minus 12 will be the total reverse voltage across that diode. So this one is the simple question. This one is from the Microtrans book. So you can go through that book also, and I will give some notes for you. So now diode application. So all logic gate we can make using diode, and we are from electronics, so we have to know some IC name for the OR gate. The IC name is 7432. In digital, we can know means what are the different gates. 7400 series, 74 series is for the logic gate. So 7432, you have to know about logic gate. Logic gate IC 7432. So OR gate, we know the symbol and A plus B and the corresponding truth table. Everyone know, I think. When both the inputs are 0, output will be 0. If any one of the input is high, output will be high. So this OR gate can be made using diode by very simple method, like two diode, because two inputs are there, D1, D2, in that fashion. So here what we are saying, that when both the inputs are 0, means 0 voltage or low value, the diode will become reverse bias. So nothing will be occur. Output will be 0, but if there will be some high voltage across this one, this diode will be conduct and that voltage will be appears across this one. Similarly, when any one means 0, this one is 0, this one is D1, open circuited, no voltage will appear, but this one is high means 1, this one is short circuited and the high voltage will be appear as a, means both are 1, so both are short circuited and the same voltage will be appear. So this one is the one of the simplest example of OR gate. You can make it for the three input, the same concept will appear. So the description AB 0, I already told both they become reverse bias and output will be 0. When any one of the input is high, A 0 1 or B 1 or A 1 B 0, either D 1 forward bias or D 2 reverse bias. So, but there should be voltage due to one diode is short circuited. And when both one high, again the high. So this one is the simplest one, simplest example of logic gate. Next one is your AND gate. So for AND gate, IC number is 7408. I am not discussing the other parameter in digital. We will tell the means how it will work or what is the significance of other one or other video lecture I will give regarding the various symbols. So, but at least you have to know 7408. Is the IC AND gate. Okay, so AND gate, very familiar, this symbol AB, truth table. I'm not discussing too much about truth table. Any one of the input is low, output is low. If both the input are high, output is high. And this one is the circuitry for the AND gate. In AND gate, what we are doing, when both the inputs are low, both the diodes are short circuited and there is a connection between supply to this ground and all current will be go like that. So it will be zero, so voltage will be zero. And if both are one, so there is no current will pass through one and this value becomes high, output will be high. So these are the some fact. AB, both the diodes become forward bias, current will flow through one of the diode and the voltage will be zero. If the above case is applicable for A equals to 0, B equals to 1, and A equals to 1 because you have both which diode D1, D2 are forward bias, that gives 0 output voltage. If both are 1, what diode become reverse bias? When both AB is 1, means D1, D2 is reverse bias. So there is no current flowing through ground because this one is reverse bias and therefore the output is logic 1 because there is no voltage drop across the resistor. So these are the simplest example for diode application. Thank you.